reject a man because he cheats. Like me personally, I will reject a man because he cheats or because he cheated. Make him understand that nah, you are going outside there to enter other girls' bekus. Me, you cannot enter my own bekus like that. Like skin to skin. You come and be doing skin doughy like that without anything. Guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Adama again here with you on Mommalistic Life. If you're seeing my face for the very first time, welcome! Like, welcome, welcome, okay? We are all new here, so consider subscribing and turning on the notification bell so that you'll be notified anytime I put up a new video, okay? I am a mommy vlogger based in Germany and I'm just here living my very ordinary life. So, today's video is a reaction video. This is something that I've never really done before and I didn't even think I was going to do something like this. But after watching this particular video from Lily Pope, of the Lily Pope TV, if you don't know her, just go to her channel, Lily Pope TV. That's the name of her channel. I'm going to also drop her link down below. Let me just tell you about her a little bit. She's a mom vlogger based in Awka, in her voice, Nigeria. She is a different whole vibe. If you have not seen anybody vibing all on her own, that would be Lily Pope. Like, she's a very interesting person, you know. When I'm watching her vlog, it just seems as if like I'm going on the journey with her. Just traveling the whole Awka or whatever she's doing, whether she's cooking or whether she's doing a challenge. Like, she has this kind of, you know, I don't know. Just go out and check out her channel and see what I'm saying for yourself. She's happily married with kids and she is rich. She's rich. Is she rich? Nah. To the best of Ihanyamhoro. Hajiego, like they have money, okay? But when I say somebody has money, like they have a big house and they drive good cars, you know, and they do what they want. That is, she and her husband, Hajiego, they have money, okay? But then, apart from that, let me just stop blabbing, guys. Lily Pope put out two videos that, in fact, personally, I don't agree with those videos, but it's okay, that's what she thinks. First of all, I'm going to start from the beginning, okay? Because there are two videos, like I said. I'm going to drop the link to both of them down below so that you can go out and check them out. In the very first video, she actually put out like her thoughts on infidelity in marriage. And infidelity in marriage, we all know, something that everybody is trying to fight, that everybody is trying to run away from. Like, everybody is praying every day, oh God, please, this one and that one. Infidelity is not a joke when it comes to a man cheating or a woman cheating. Like, this is not just something you wish for yourself. But in Lily Pope's case, in her very first video, she put it out there that actually when she was growing up, like, you know, when she was still a young abogo that was not yet married, I think, if I'm not wrong, go and check out the video. So she was talking with her father and she asked her father about infidelity and all that. Father made her understand that all men cheat, that there is not a man out there that does not cheat. This will be because that when this place, according to how she also said it, you know, in, of course, paraphrased, that when this place lies, men's down below, okay, like their third leg, when it stands, that their brain is not thinking, you know, so they have to always use that third leg first. And after, with their brain will kind of come, they will come back to their senses and then their brain will start working again and be like, oh, what's happening? Why did you do this? Like, the regret will come in and all that. But Lily Pope, like, honestly, I understand your own point of view. Like, this video is not to fight you or anything. Like, this is me also sharing my own perspective. I do not agree with that. And this is in the sense that there is something called self-control. Okay, self-control is a virtue, is a gift, is whatever you want to call it. When your third leg stands and you are able to stop yourself, or even for women, we have, you know, temptations every day here and there. But your ability to tell yourself stop, ability to hold yourself back, that is what is called self-control. And there is something called that. All men do not cheat. All men do not cheat, like, honestly speaking. But let me just finish, you know, analyzing, you know, what she and her father said. And then, because of what her father told her, she now came to the conclusion that all men cheat, of course. So this is what she has had in her mind, kind of growing up and becoming the adult and the woman she is today. She still has it in her mind. And she has this very strong perception that all men cheat. And she also says that you shouldn't, of course, leave your marriage because your husband cheated. Even me, like, of course, you should, depending on the level of cheating anyway, because there are different levels of cheating, we should be able to forgive. The Bible says that marriage is a bed undefiled. That means you should keep it holy the way it is. Like, it should be two people. Okay? To the best of my knowledge, that is what marriage is. That is what any relationship should be. I don't care whether it's married or not. Okay? But that is what any relationship should be. When you are no longer together, then you can, like, separate and go in separate ways and start, you know, fiddling or doing whatever you want with anybody. But I know that a lot of men are not able to hold themselves. And this makes it a norm, especially for women who are not doing anything, who do not have, you know, that extra money coming in to them. Women who are not empowered, financially especially, tend to, like, hide under the apron strings of these men. So considering whatever they do is okay, whether they cheat and bring STDs to the house, it's okay. But okay, so now Lily Pope said whether her husband is cheating or not, that is none of her business, as long as she's not seeing it, as long as she doesn't know about it. Of course, there is even this Igbo adage that said, "Ihe mahama hoge," like, what you do not know does not know you. Now, if her husband is going to cheat, of course her husband now knows exactly what to do, how to do it and all that. But that man doesn't look to me like somebody who has that kind of time anyway. You know, there's some people, they write it on their faces, right? But Lily's husband doesn't look like that kind of person to me, because he's this quiet person and all that, whether he drinks or not. Because Lily also said that all these men that go to drink one bottle and two bottles, that all of them cheat. Like, seriously, I don't know. My husband doesn't drink, okay? My husband doesn't drink, doesn't chase women. Like, honestly speaking, to the best of my knowledge, you know, what you don't know does not know you. So I've been married for 12 years, like 12 years. In all these 12 years, I have not had a cause to, like, suspect my husband of anything. In fact, he doesn't have that kind of time. That was one of the reasons why I married him. Because, like, seriously, during my Abogo days, like, I never dated any person who didn't cheat, okay? And I prayed to God that, "God, Biko, please. Like, this is something I hate. This is something that I can actually, like, if it gets too much, if it gets to the point that I can no longer take it, like, this is something that can make me walk out of a relationship." In fact, it made me walk out of every single relationship that I had that time, even though I didn't have many, okay? But I walked out because of those things. Like, it was one of the main reasons why I just had to say, well, let me just go, okay? So I just prayed to God and said, "God, Biko, please, you know the kind of person I am." It seems nekope kope sometimes, and I don't know what I'm going to do if this happens, but please, God, give me a man that will be there for me of cheating or anything like that. And I also prayed for God not to give me a man that for God to give me a man that doesn't drink. Like, honestly speaking, I got that person. And then Lily also said that, well, that all these handsome young men, my dear, not all handsome young men cheat. In fact, they know they do them for handsome. Even the ugliest people, you know, they do. Like, God, the guy is handsome, so he cheats. No, like, I'm married to the most handsome guy ever. Like, seriously, I'm not bragging. But let's just say that, of course, everyone to their own out there, and you are thinking that you can sit down and take, you know, cheating. Like, there are people that are, how will I even put it? These people are unrepentant, serial cheats. These people cheat like tomorrow, no day. They'll cheat with your friend, they'll cheat with your sister. In fact, they will even try to get all the people around you, they will draw them close to them for them to come and, you know, do the thing with them. I don't know what their problem is, whether they have a problem with themselves or whether they have, I do not know. But like Lipo says that if you want to cheat, that you should go far, 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 far. Well, that is her. Oh, my own is, don't even cheat at all. Like, whether you are doing it there or here, don't even cheat at all. And there's also something very wrong that she said. She said that you shouldn't worry about whether a man cheats or not. If you are just a boyfriend, just, you know, a partner, I will leave you because you cheated. Because if you are cheating when we are in an ordinary relationship, nobody knows what is going to happen when we are married. I'm telling you, nobody knows what is going to happen. Whether you repent, so whether you don't repent, I don't know. I don't even know whether you're going to repent tomorrow. So the one I'm seeing today, that's the one that I'm going to work with. I will leave you. Girl, you cannot see fire and go put your hand in there. That's not right. Nobody does that. Boso. Because if somebody is cheating and saying I'm sorry every day, I'm saying I'm sorry and coming back to you when you guys are not married, what you're going to see in that marriage? Na me, they're sorry for you. So, if somebody is cheating when you guys are not married, my sister, run for your life, because HEDM, which basically means no one knows tomorrow. Nobody knows what is going to happen tomorrow. And I tell you, most times it gets worse. So, run. According to Lily, like, this is how she has built her happy home, at least around this notion. She's not thinking about whether her husband is cheating, which is okay. Like, it's okay, okay? Like I said before, everyone to their own. But me personally, I know my husband doesn't cheat. In 12 years, he hasn't cheated on me, okay? I would say the one that I know of, or people come and start commenting, you don't know, or this one and that one. I know my husband inside out. Like, inside out. Like this. Of course, everybody should know their husbands, okay? So I know that it's not that he won't cheat or something like that, but this is not his thing. And I'm happy for that. Like, and then, so, but the fact that men will cheat and bring STDs, and Lily says that, no, that STD will not come to you. It will kill them and we bury them. I know a lot of women who have died because of sicknesses, because of illnesses that their husband brought with their third leg into their marriage, without these innocent women knowing, and they died. These people died. Some people are still alive, carrying HIV/AIDS. Like, I have, like, a number of people that I know. My mom runs an NGO, and every day we see these kind of cases. You don't even want to go there. If you know that your husband is cheating, make sure you use protection with him. I don't care. Make sure he uses protection every time. If you forgive, make sure he uses protection and start going for tests. If you want skin to skin, come, let's go for tests. Like, this should be you. You should not open your legs wide and take it all in the name of love, or in the name of your marriage, or in the name of, what will people say? When you know that he has been going up and down, don't try, because you're going to totally regret it. But if I know you are doing it, and you out there, if you know your husband is doing it, but use your own money, go and buy protection. You know, this rubber protection, buy it and let him use it wherever he comes or whenever you want to do it. First of all, bring it out, open it. Oh yeah, brother, honey, whatever. Oh yeah, put this thing here. That will even make him to stop. That will even make him to reduce whatever he's doing out there. A lot of men will not want to do that. He will reduce how he's going outside. And when he knows that you are adamant about it and you're not even changing and you're not even shaking, he will think twice. No, no, no. You have to put something there to enter there. Okay? So that you will save yourself. Because your children, my sister, if he gets some kind of crazy illness that is going to kill him, let him die alone so that you can be alive to train your kids. Okay, that is what it should be. Make sure you use protection and don't even shake. When I say don't shake, don't tell him, no, I cannot do. Let him take you to village meeting, umada meeting, and all those places. Be carrying that thing up and that, say he must use this thing. He's going out there. Be strong. Open your mouth and talk. Your husband is not going to kill you. You cannot open your legs like that because you think, yes, it will not come to me. What he has will not come to me. God will not allow it to happen because I am holy. I am praying. I'm keeping myself holy. Remember, even Job, even God allowed those calamities to fall upon Job. Then ask yourself, who am I? Who am I that God will not allow these things to happen or to come to me? So, be careful. Tread carefully. If he wants to go outside and you know he's going outside, save yourself. This rubber thing out there, it doesn't cost much. Even me, I will put two. And before, if it's just about going skin though, with skin to skin with me, then let us go and do tests and be sure that he's clean before he starts again. And when I catch him again, we go back to square one. We go back to square one from where we started. Like, I'm not even joking. I don't know about you. This is my own view. This is what I think. If you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it for you, make sure you hit that subscribe button. click the notification bell so that you'll be notified next time I upload another video, and I'll see you in my next. Bye.